Yeah, what's up, everyone? Welcome to FILMspiration, the place where filmmakers come to get inspired. My name's writer-director Edgar Ibarra. Let's get down to business. So, I'm here to invite you all to the screening of the short film Get Up 8. Here's the backstory on it. About a month ago, I was blessed to basically come together with and work with the following actors and actresses locally here in Tucson in no particular order. We've got Mr. Jonathan Galvez. We also have Mr. Bobby Fleming, Chris Green, Dana Maiello, Heather Serrano, Joey Santofanti, Roxanne Baldenegro, Tamika Simmons, her daughters Grace Simmons, and also JJ Simmons. And I just wanted to, David, hey David, what's up? How are you? Thank you for saying hello. Good to have you on here. Thank you so much. David Wing, how are you doing, sir? Good to see you on here as well. Basically, just wanted to guys to invite you all out to the screening of the short film Get Up 8. Dropped a trailer to the film last Saturday. I know it was just this past Saturday, but I will be actually putting it in, if you guys give me just 1 minute to refresh my screens, which is why I set this whole thing up the way I did behind me. I'm going to be dropping the trailer into the comments if you all want to check it out right now. Hey, David Valdez, how you doing, brother? So there's the comment in the comments. You guys will find the trailer, and I'll also put it in the body in the description once I'm done. I was blessed to work with this cast of 10 on a short film that we did with a really, really great message with all the actors and the actresses. The movie's got a lot of heart. It was made with a lot of heart, a lot of blood, especially sweat. And well, not really blood, but you know what I mean, especially the sweat. No tears involved, thankfully, but lots of sweat. And Jacob Johnson, thank you so much for watching, brother. We ran around north of the downtown area all Saturday, and then also here at the east side all Saturday, not this past Saturday but the one before, and just had a great day starting at like 6:30 a.m. jumped right into it, and we just rolled throughout the day, and I just had such a blast being back in, sorry, I was scratching my foot. I just had a blast being back in my element, of just being behind the camera and working with people and doing what I'm able to do, but I was only able to do it because I worked with a great group of people, all the actors and the actresses who, you know, we took this journey together, who also wanted to create, who also wanted to make something. And I'm always super inspired whenever people come forth and say, you know what? Yeah, let's make something and let's do something. And so, Pablo, how you doing, man? Nice to see you on here, brother. Pablo, if you can make it out to, if you and your brother can make it out to Tucson on Saturday evening for a night of independent cinema, very similar to what you all had down in Sierra Vista, we would love for you guys to be here. Greatly appreciate you guys coming out and, seeing the film stuff that, we ran around making on Saturday. Now, one of the things that I want to point out is that it's never easy to run out and make a short independent film. Pablo, I know you know all about this, bro. I know a lot of us know all about this. It really does take commitment to the character, commitment to studying the text, the commitment to studying the script, every single little nook and cranny, every single little look, every moment, every pause, every beat, every single one of these little things. Pablo, so all of that information I'm going to be putting on the, I already posted it on here. So it's going to be this coming Saturday at 8 p.m. The address and all the information is already in the, hi Becky, how are you? The address and all the information is already in the body of the, of this post. And if you just catch it, and then also, Renee, hey, how you doing, man? ¿Cómo estás, hermano? All that information is in the body of the post, and I'll also go ahead and put it in the comments below also, but you can find the trailer in the film, and all of that is on the screen. The trailer you can see in the, hey Mina, what's going on? The trailer you can see in the comments right now. I just posted it in the comments of this post, and that's really weird because I'm watching myself right there in the background. It's like Inception. It's a live video within a live video within a live video. Eat your heart out, Christopher Nolan. Ooh. All right. bad comedy. Anyway, so yeah, would love to have you. Pablo, would love to have you and your brother, anybody else who'd want to come on out, man. Just a fun little night, very similar to what you guys did in Sierra Vista. We are going to have, it'll be $5 at the door, $3 for the kiddos. I'm happy my wife brought that up because, yeah, $3 for the kiddos, 18 and under. We will have free popcorn and also beverages for like a dollar for like a can of soda if you, you know, if you have diet needs and whatnot. Bottles of water, we will have all of that also. Ultimate live steps. Yeah, right? That's funny. Now I'm just, you're just starting in the back. You're just starting in the back. In the back of what? Let me know, brother. So it'll be, again, $5 at the door, $3 for the kiddos, free popcorn, as well as soda for a dollar. Gonna set up a screen, audio system, and also the projector, and nothing too fancy, but again, it all comes from, and I don't want to like pull the camera down, it all comes from like right here, right from the heart. This was literally blood, sweat, and tears, you know, getting out there into the very warm sun, which, by the way, we had to be very, very careful because it was one of the staring. Oh, so you're literally staring into yourself. Is that what you mean, Pablo? As I hold my finger over myself in the background. Sorry about that. You know, it's going to be nothing too fancy. It's a screen. We're going to have chairs there. I encourage everyone else to also bring chairs out. This is going to be, let me give you guys the right location. It's 3227 North First Avenue. It's going to be on the northwest quadrant of First and Fort Lowell, right next door to SWAG, the Southwest Artist Group. It's going to be in that courtyard, and we invite anyone and everyone to come on out and just to enjoy a night of independent cinema done by folks, myself included, who just, we ran around, you know, certain parts of Tucson, Speedway and I-10, that area, as well as First and Fort Lowell, as well as on the east side. You know, just a fun day of running around and making a short film. David, thanks for the invite. Headed out tomorrow. David, well, I hope, you know, you'll be able to check it out. Because afterwards it's going to go online. Maybe not immediately afterwards, but as soon as possible, I will get it out online for everyone to enjoy, because that's ultimately one of the things that I like to also express is that, you know, the cinema that the great actors and actresses who embarked on this journey with me, one of the things that I set out to do was also ultimately share. And I know the route, you know, is traditionally many times for film festivals and whatnot, and that's fine, and I respect those who go that route. My route here is I just want to share with the world, and I just want to make sure that almost instantaneously or as soon as possible that the fruits of the labor of these actors and actresses is seen. And so you guys will definitely get a chance to check it out online. I will be putting it out online on my YouTube channel as well as here on Facebook in time. But David, no worries, brother. I'm honored that you'd want to come on up, brother. But travel safe. Do travel safe. And I do look forward to seeing you out in the field one of these days, pretty soon. But yeah, you guys just come on out to the screening. And if you guys ever have wanted to see independent film, you know, done at the grassroots level, and I'm talking about, you know, some money involved, but more than anything, a lot of heart, a lot of effort, a lot of blood, sweat, and tears. If you've ever been curious of what an independent film is like, this is the opportunity, you guys, to come on and check this out. I mean, we really do encourage you to kind of see and feel and experience what absolute grassroots independent cinema is like. Pablo, and I have another thing before I go into that, before I lose my train of thought. So going into grassroots independent cinema, you know, this is the thing that we do, that we filmmakers love to do. And so, Pablo, let me go ahead and read your comment. Heck yeah, Terry's making up 6 hours. Check it out, the trailer. Awesome. Yeah, brother, check out the trailer. Like I said, I'm going to have the link in the body of the description once this post is over. And then afterwards, it is now, as of now, in the comment section. So you can just kind of click on that. Maybe it opens up in another window. I don't know. And then, you know, just check out the video. It's It's more of a montage video. It kind of gives you a look and a feel of what the story is going to be like. Now, in a vague sense. Now, why I say in a vague sense is because the actors and actresses work their butts off. The hours that were put into this, not just the day of the shoot, but also in preparation, the characters, the rehearsals, etc. So as to not give away the secret sauce. Robert Linden, what's going on, brother? As to not give away the secret sauce, you know, the overall conclusion of the film. The movie's basically based upon a good message of here's one question that will kind of lead you into it. How far would you go for a friend? Paul Lowe, Paul, what's going on, brother? How are you? And that's kind of what the story is about. One friend sees that another friend is in trouble, and the question is now, okay, does, you know, our person do something about that? Do they go and do something about that? And do they go and basically try to get their friend, this guy, and another group of characters try to get their friend out of trouble and out of harm's way? Or do they just kind of like cross their arms, stand by, and hope that everything turns out fine, you know? And it really is, it's a movie that takes place in, you know, our real world. So it's something that could basically happen, or maybe it has happened to a lot of us, to where you're faced with a question like, how far would you go to help a friend? Would you help a friend? Would you give up on a friend ultimately? And so that's kind of a vague description of the premise of the movie. Again, vague because I'm not going to give away the secret sauce. These actors and actresses worked their butts off and, you know, to bring the story and make the story come to life. And they all did an amazing job. And, you know, we hope that you guys really enjoy this. Now, I had another thing that I wanted to say. Robert, what's going on, brother? Hello, how you doing, man? I had another thing that I wanted to say about independent film, with regards to just, you know, going out and doing. Mary Carol, hey, how you doing, Mary Carol? How are you? Filmmaking is a thing that you very much have to give yourself to in the moment. Now, what I mean by that is, you know, it's not a thing that you can do from the sidelines, you know, maybe in the Hollywood image of things, the director sitting in the chair, he's under a tent, he's being fanned by, you know, other people, you know. Okay, that's that, and great for, you know, all of the people that experience it that way. But, you know, in this sense, to run out there and make a film, I mean, it really takes dedication and effort, whether if it was as certain actors and actresses, you know, whether if it was only like 4 or 5 hours for them, whether for other people it was 7 or 8 hours. In my case, it spanned basically the entire day. But the point I'm getting at is that you have to step into this. You have to love the discomfort that comes along with creating. And if you don't like it, and if most people don't like it, you wouldn't be doing this. So in other words, what I'm saying of a very inverted manner is the actors and the actresses, and also Christina Sosserman, who gave very much of herself, couldn't participate in the production, still said, you know what, Edgar, I still want to help. How can I help? And she actually, Christina Sosserman actually did sound and lighting, and she was amazing. But, you know, you have to find joy in creating. And this is definitely a group that found joy and passion. If it wasn't already there, then, you know, they definitely experienced the joy and the passion that comes with creating, because guess what? It's not easy. Pablo, you're a filmmaker. I know you know that. And so, okay, I can dig it. Really enjoy real life scenario films. Excited. Heads up. Awesome. Oh, yes. Oh, question and answer. Yes. That's, of course, my train of thought. You know, the caboose went off the rails a long time ago. Yes. Question and answer. So let me talk to you guys about that. Just close up my previous thought. Lucia del Valle. Hey, how are you? Thank you for jumping aboard. So, yeah, basically, like, you know, if you're watching people run out there on a Saturday at 6:30 a.m. when no one is making them do this, and they're doing this, you know, for a variety of reasons, one of them being, you know, and I hope probably the most important is because you love to do it, then, you know, I really respect that. I really respect that. And there's no greater blessing than a group of people who say, you know what, I'm with you. Bam, let's do this. And so Maribel Ibarra, best wife ever. How are you doing, my love? So I really respect that. Now, Pablo, question and answer. So yes, there will be a question and answer. I would love for you guys, the audience, to be able to talk to the cast and our two-person crew members. And, you know, just ask away. Ask whatever you guys would like to ask with regards to the filmmaking experience. I would so appreciate that because, I mean, I know you guys have, you know, questions, and I know that the cast and crew would definitely be very, very pleased to, like, you know, share whatever the knowledge and whatever, you know, experiences they want to share from the filmmaking experience. Anything that you want to know, that's within their power to speak to. And I would love for that. Yeah, so we are going to have a question and answer because it's not just about showing the film and then we wrap up and we're gone. No, it's about, you know, let's talk about it afterwards, like the filmmaking process, the filmmaking experience. And let's really do like a deep dive into basically what went into this. And or maybe you guys aren't going to go that deep with the questions in the Q&A afterwards. I don't know. I'll leave it up to you guys. Leave it up to the organic process. But you know, I would love to be able to, you know, have you guys experience this with the actors and the actresses. And afterwards, we'll all just hang out, basically. We all just hang out and just enjoy each other's company. If for the reason of just the organic passion of organic independent filmmaking. I mean, you know, those of you who've known me for a while know that, like, you know what? You know, I talk that talk, but I also love to walk that walk. And this is one of those moments when I'm more than happy to walk the walk. It has not been easy from day one till now. And it continues to not be easy as I see the editing process through. But I mean, it's a labor of love. I know that that is like super cliche, but it's labor. So it's work, but it's work that we all have loved to do. And Pablo, you will ask questions, bro? I know you'll ask questions, man. I really do hope that you and your brother can make it out. Hold on, like, my mouth is going really dry. Check this out. Ooh, water. So anyway, now I'm good to talk for a whole lot more time. But yeah, come on out, everyone. We'd definitely love to have you there. Again, the trailer for Get Up 8, this story with a lot of heart, with a great message, posing the question, how far would you go for a friend? It's going to be this Saturday, 8 p.m. at 3227. I want to make sure I'm getting that right. 3227 North First Avenue on the northwest quadrant of First and Fort Lowell. Again, $5 at the door, $3 for the kiddos, free popcorn, $1 drinks, nothing too fancy. Melissa, hey, how you doing? Nothing too fancy. We're going to have chairs there. If you guys want to bring your own lawn chairs or those stadium, well, you guys know which ones I'm talking about. Like, I don't even have the words to describe the ones you set out at, like, if you go and watch like a soccer game or, you know, something like that, you guys know what I mean. If you guys, have any of those, bring those out, you know, bring your family and your friends. And, if you are the family and friends of the actors and the actresses, oof. I really do encourage you to come on out and check out this film. Yes, I've already gone on at length about, you know, the blood, sweat, and tears, the passion, the dedication, and the discipline that was exhibited by each and every single one of the actors and the actresses in this short film. But that way you can see...
Pablo, look at that.
That way you all can see, basically... the fruits of their labor. Like, you know, I know a lot of times we all may know someone that, you know, where you say like, oh, you're a filmmaker, you're an actress. Okay, where's the thing that you've been in? Where can I see your movies? This is your opportunity to kind of have that question answered in this very specific case. One of the things, again, I kind of touched upon this briefly beforehand. Pablo, let me see what you say, brother. All right. Yeah, there's Saturday. I'm stoked. All right, brother. Cool, man. Looking forward to seeing you and your brother. Would love to have you guys there and would be honored to have you guys there. Yeah, see you then, man. And so where was I? Where was I before? What was I talking about? This is your opportunity, again, friends and family of the actors and actresses, to see, you know, who, you know, if it's your sister, your brother, your dad, your mom, your, you know, whoever the actor, the actress is to you, this is your opportunity to get to see what they do and what is coming, like literally coming from their heart, in their actions, through their acting, out of their dialogue. You know, this is your opportunity to see that other part of them. And I really do want to invite you to all to check out that aspect of everyone that was in this film, because it's a very special moment when we can share a screening. And Pablo, you know about this, brother, as a filmmaker, it's a very special moment when you work really hard at something and finally it's time to share it. And it might even be a little nerve-wracking, but you know, that's what it really comes down to, is being able to share, you know, from an actor or an actress's point of view, or not that I'm an actor or an actress, but also from a filmmaker's point of view, like, hey, this is who I am, this is what I do, we made a thing, come and check this out. Bam. That's kind of about it, you guys. So everyone, again, check out the trailer to Get Up 8, a short film written and directed by yours truly, starring a great cast and crew, and again, in no particular order, if I can get my phone open on time to keep up with my mouth, Jonathan Galvez, Bobby Fleming, Chris Green, Dana Maiello, Heather Serrano, Joey Santofanti, Roxanne Valdenegro, Tamika Simmons, JJ Simmons, and Grace Simmons. Would definitely love to have you all out there. And I just encourage you guys to come on out and, you know, support truly independent cinema and, you know, the people who have literally put their hearts, their minds, their body, their, especially, you know, physical bodies, of like going out there and, you know, spending all these hours doing this crazy thing we call filmmaking in the heat, safely though, hydration, you know, to experience what we bring to the table. And I would definitely love for you all to be there. If you guys have any questions, hit me up in the DMs, or also check out the trailer. Again, I'm going to put that trailer in the description or the body of this post once I finish up in just a few minutes. It's already in the comments below right now. So thank you so much, everyone, for to each and every single one of you for dropping by. And I hope to see you there this Saturday night. You will see this mug once again. I'm going to try to do another blast out like this tomorrow, Thursday night, maybe one late Friday, maybe one on Saturday. So basically, keep your eyes peeled and open. And I'm going to be out there. And so... Why am I going to basically get out there and get out there and get out there? Because I would love for you guys to be there. Everyone, thank you so much. My name is Edgar Ibarra, writer, director, and come on out to check out Get Up 8 and support all of the great local talent here that there is in Tucson, the great local filmmaking that goes on. And headed up there is that, Pablo, that was our previous comment, and I'm sorry, I started reading it again. Would definitely love to have each and every single one of you out here on Saturday night. So thank you so much, everyone. And you can also catch this post on the YouTubes, as well as the Twitters and the Instagrams. I've been very lazy about that. I've been saying that for a few times now, but I will be better about Twitter and Instagram. Anyway, I hope to see you guys there on Saturday evening. That's this Saturday evening, 8 p.m., Tucson, Arizona, 3227 North First Avenue. On the northwest quadrant, right next to a lamp store. And you guys can park in the back, and you guys can also enter through the back. It's between the building. There's going to be a big parking lot between Catholic Church on the backside and then our building. So you guys will know exactly what I'm talking about. And our building is the white one, 3227 North First Avenue. Hope to see you guys there. Love each and every single one of you, and thank you for supporting, and thank you for dropping in every single one, or every single body. Choose, Edgar, but choose wisely. Every single body who dropped in and left a comment to chit-chat and say hello, I appreciate it. Love you guys. See you guys on Saturday. Adios.